गुड इवनिंग गाइस, गुड इवनिंग। सो शैल वी स्टार्ट गाइस आवर सेशन। यस, सो इन द लास्ट सेशन गाइस, इन द लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एट्रिब्यूट्स गाइस, HTML attributes discussed guys. Okay, so I'll give you overview about the attributes and we will discuss today concept. So attributes used for what purpose? What is the use of attributes? Means attributes giving some extra information to the existing HTML tags. To the tags, particular the extra information if you want to be add. Then we can use attributes guys. So attributes where we are writing, means along with open tag we are writing guys. Attributes we are writing along with open tag. So inside the open tag, for example, h1 tag is there, here some hello content is there, and you're going to be closing h1. So here this is open tag and this is close tag. So along with open tag we are going to write the attribute. Okay, attribute syntax guys. Attribute syntax, name equal to value format we are writing, name equal to value. Okay, so guys, here the value always in the form of double quotes we are writing guys. Okay, double quotes we are writing within the quotes format we are writing like a string value. So simply you can see here syntax, attribute name equal to attribute value. Okay, this one guys. So here attribute names guys, can we write user defined names? Attribute names I'm asking. I told yesterday, are you remembering? So attribute names, can we write user defined? I'm asking. Here some people giving yes answer, that is not correct guys. Okay, attribute names are only predefined. So this basic points important. Again, I'm telling this concept, don't worry guys, by means up to day end, n number of times we are going to use attribute concepts. That's why I'm telling again. Okay, so attribute names always predefined values. Okay, and attribute values can be user defined and can be predefined, both. Okay, so attribute values user defined and are predefined also, but most of the times attribute values are user defined values. That point remember. Okay, mostly user defined, 90% user defined we are using. So slowly we'll understanding how we are writing everything. Okay, so this is called attribute name guys, and this is attribute value. So values always in between the double quotes we are writing. Single quotes also we can use. Coding standards. This is a coding standard within the double quotes we are giving. Clear? So attribute name equal to value format we are giving inside open tag. And next point guys, for single tag guys, this is one tag. For one tag, n number of attributes we can write. For one tag, one attribute, that is not rule. For one tag, we can write n number of attributes depending on situation. For example, ID equal to some value, class equal to some value, my class I'm taking. Okay, so here like different names we can take it guys, blah blah blah, different attribute names we can take it. Okay, so slowly we will discuss what is the use of ID related value, what is the use of class related value, like these all things slowly we will discuss, don't worry. First, how to writing, that point remember. Okay, now so in the last session table concept we discussed guys, table concept. In the table border attribute I used, table border equal to some one, like something we are writing. Because of this border attribute, for this table borderlines we got it. Okay, coming days guys, using the bootstrap, we have the bootstrap concept. Using the bootstrap, we are going to be developing the tables. More beautifully we can develop tables using Bootstrap. Real time must be people are using most of the times Bootstrap only to design tables. But right now we don't know how to write the Bootstrap. That's why using HTML how to design, that is we need to be discussed. And the same concept we are using inside the Bootstrap also, some additional classes, additional attributes we are using because of that beautiness you are going to get for your table. Proper designing you are going to be getting. That's it. Okay. So this is enough guys about the attributes. Remember later we will use these all attributes slowly, slowly. Okay, here one word answer I'll give you about the attributes. So I have n number of H1 tags guys. So here this H1 related hello message there. Now here welcome message there. Welcome message there. Okay. Again, I have one more H1. So, for example, like a Srinivas, I'm taking, okay? Something else, whatever you want. So one more H1, like hi message there, assumption. So like N number of H1 tags there, guys. N number of H1 tags there in my page, guys, in my page, okay? So if you want, select all H1s, guys, all H1s, and if you want to be providing the CSS styles, okay, no? So CSS styles, if you want to be provide, then we can use H1 tag, guys. We can use H1 tag, okay? So generally you can see here, if you want to provide all these four tags, one common style, simply we can use, later I will tell about the CSS, don't worry. So now here you're going to be writing, guys, okay? So in this, whatever the styles you want, you can write red color, I want to get a background color, I want to get a borderline, I want to get like whatever you want, you can make it here. Okay. So if you are using H1 guys, all four H1s selecting and applying the same styles here. Okay. That is H1 tag. Now I don't want to select all H1s. I want to select only this first H1. Only this one I want to select. Then using this ID related value, we can select a particular H1. So now my ID value is what? My ID. So simply you can write has my ID. The syntax, everything I will tell, wait sometime. Okay. So now just you are going to be using as here, whatever the styles you want, you can use it. Whatever the styles you want, you can use it. Okay. Now these styles, guys, these styles, wherever ID equal to my ID is there, selecting that one and applying there, finding that one, applying there. Has symbol representing here, ID. Where ID equal to my ID is there, that is going to be finding, and to the tag applying these styles. Okay, means what is this attribute value behavior out of all H1 tags, specific H1 going to be selecting. Like that, n number of benefits there using the attributes. Clear, all of you? Why required attributes means this is the concept. So class having its own behavior, ID having its own behavior, and different attributes there. So when concept coming slowly, slowly, we will discuss. Got it? IDs, guys, IDs are unique values. ID values are the unique values in entire HTML. In entire HTML, same ID value don't take only one time. For example, for first H1, ID, my ID, I take N. So for the second H1, again, ID, you can take it, but value should be different one. Don't take my ID. If you are taking my ID, both are getting red mark and showing error. Okay. So I'm going to take my ID 2, just assumption guys, my ID 2. So now if I'm using my ID 2, this tag going to be selecting. If I'm using my ID, then this is going to be selecting. If you are using H1, then these all are going to be selecting. All are going to be selecting. Like that, ID values, we can use it. Now class there guys, class can be duplicate. Class value can be duplicate, okay? Same class value we can give to the another tags also. And now what is this meaning means? Using this class related value, guys, if you want to be providing CSS styles to HTML tags, then you can use, okay, both same class there. Means at a time, out of these four H1 tags, selecting first H1 tag as this one, selecting first H1 and selecting this third H1. Means out of all the tags, some group of tags, you are going to be filtered, you are going to be finding, and later you are going to be applying the styles. Okay, now? So ID behavior, out of all the tags, specific tag, only single tag you are finding and applying the styles. But using the class value, some group of tags at a time we can find, and common styles we can apply. Okay, and if you are using the tag name, guys, directly, tag name, if you are using, all at a time selecting all tags. So this tag name selecting, ID name related selecting, class related selecting, n number of times we are using while developing applications. In entire UI, guys, there is three variations. So many times we are going to use. Not only this, n number of things there, but these three are most important. ID, class related, and next tag based related CSS. This is the tag based CSS, ID based CSS, class based CSS. At the time of discussing the CSS, we will discuss programmatically this all again one more time. Come on, is it understanding everyone? So far. Give reply, guys. Okay. Now, right now, this is enough about the attributes, not required much more. Later, we will discuss again. So, yes. Okay. So, I'll tell slowly, guys. Don't worry. Okay. So, finally, attributes giving some extra information to the HTML tags, that point, remember. And using these attribute-related values, we can identify the particular tag. Okay, using the attribute related values, we can identify. After identifying particular tag, what we can do, that is, at the time of discussing the CSS, we will discuss, guys. Right now, you don't know how to write this CSS. Okay, no? And table border, guys, why we are using table border means, to providing the border lines to our table, to providing the border lines to our table, we use this border attribute. Otherwise, without border, only columns and the content you are getting. Columns and the content you are getting. In the last session, I explained and output wise I showed. Okay, again I will show you now. Wait. So open our previous program. PyCharm I open now here. PyCharm opening and it's loading little. So previously created opened project, it is opening, guys. Don't worry, this is not related to you. So I want to open here. Click on the file, guys. And now here, if you want, you can click open, our system will open. There you can select our current folder. Otherwise here, guys, open recent there, guys. Open recent there. So click on the file, click on the open recent. Then you're getting recently opened projects you're going to get. So we opened in the last session, our batch related this one. Select this one. That's it. Okay. So click on the file. Open recent and NTH 8 p.m. So this window. Yes. See, now I'm going to be executing this program. Okay. So here browsers there, guys. So click on this browser. You're going to be getting output. So here can see output. So these border lines, if you want to get, guys, border you are going to use. So if I'm not using this border, then what happened, can see, guys. So This is you are getting. So table borders, if you want, border equal to we are writing. That's it. Okay? Remember that. So right now I told you guys ID attribute, just assumption here. ID equal to something my ID. This is one attribute. So using this, we can provide the CSS. How to provide right now, you don't know. That's why I'm telling wait some time. Okay. Otherwise, I'll show you here right now. Just accept this input. Later, we have concept that time more clearly we will discuss. So inside the head section, we are going to use one style tag. So using this style tag, guys, CSS styles we are going to be providing. Later, we have session, guys, separately. That time, we will discuss more clearly. Okay. So now here, string format we need to give, guys, here. Now, H1 tag you are going to be using. So this value, first of all, H1 tag I'm using, guys. H1 tag. So here, color, red color I want. By default, HTML displaying block color content, block color text. I want red color. Then H1 tag wherever available inside the body, that tag content getting the red color. Now you can see here, student information, red color you are getting. Actually, block color getting. Okay. So now here the one more line, control D, duplicate. See here, guys, ID values not duplicate, I told. That's why error showing. You can change it my ID to different value. Okay. So now here the student data I'm taking, no problem. Okay. Now H1 tag you are selecting means, so wherever H1 tag is there, guys, inside the body, in these two tags, applying the same styles, red color text. Okay. See, red color you're getting both. Okay, now. And now, first one ID, my ID is there, guys. So using ID value, if you want to provide CSS, has my ID we are taking, guys. Has symbol representing where ID equal to my ID is there. Has representing ID. Where ID equal to my ID is there inside body tags. That tag identified, this one. Now for this, I want to be provide a background color, some yellow color I want to be provide. Background, for this content background you are going to be getting. Now can see here, background you are getting. Okay, actually two are H1 tags only, but because of ID only this is selected and you are getting. Clear? Like that, using attributes, guys, using these attributes, we can do something. We can identify particular elements and later whatever we want, we can do it. Is it clear? So these all are comes under CSS providing, styling providing to our HTML page. Later we will discuss about these all. That's it. Both HTML and CSS combination together, if we are developing as a starting onwards, like that presentation wise, bit colors wise, we can display. But first of all, we need to focus some days about the HTML. Later we will discuss about the CSS. That time both together we can develop. Okay, now? Yes. Okay, now my HTML done. And now today I want to be discussing about the some new tags, guys. Some new tags. So OL tag is there, and the UL tag is there, and the LI tag is there. Three. Now I want to be discussing. Okay. So in the last session, guys, so table related, lot of tags we created. Table, and next what, guys? T head tag, and next T body, and next TR, okay, and next TH, and next TD. These all combination tables we are going to be designing. Okay, now, so these all combinations, guys. These all combinations. You're going to get the table, guys. You're going to be creating tables. Now, these things guys, these three are one combination. Order list, YL means order list, UL means unordered list, LI means list item. Order list, unordered list, list item. Okay, these all tags comes under list tags guys, list item tags or else list tags. List tags we are calling list tags. Okay, so I want to display guys some institute related information. For example, our NTH organization is there, NTH. So NTH organization providing what courses. So information I want to display. Okay, using this list tags guys, some list of information we can display, same kind of information. For example, you can see here I'm going to be developing, okay, my requirement this one guys, available languages, available languages are okay. Now here I want to be display guys, I want to display for example python, next java, and next C language. Okay, for example, like three things I want to display. Next guys, available courses, available databases, available databases, or else available frameworks, like whatever you want, you can do it. So next, numbers I don't want, just dots I want, dots. Okay, so now here for example MySQL. Okay, next guys, Oracle, and next MongoDB. Nowadays more training DB, this one. Okay, MongoDB, like I want to be display. Okay, this is like a heading guys, and these are like a values. Like if you want, you can display. This is my browser. Okay, so like some question and answers wise related guys, heading and answers related wise, you can display here. Okay, so actually headers representing purpose, we are using H1 to H6 tags. Normal paragraph content displaying purpose, we are using paragraph tags. Now here some available languages means a group of languages you are displaying here. Okay, some list of languages. That's why we can use OL tag here, OL tag. Because of the OL tag, these numbers you are going to be getting. Ordered list, OL means ordered list. Nothing but numbers you are going to be getting. 1, 2, 3, like that. For example, 30 names I given guys. So by seeing this number 30, we can know how many elements there, 30 elements there. There elements means each one is like an element. Okay, 30 elements there we can. Okay guys, next, by using this UL tag, this kind of information you can display. Dot symbols representing nothing but unordered. Okay, so here right now 3 there, if 30 there guys, for example if 30 elements there, so we are unable to identify how many are there. We need to be count each one, 1, 2, 3, like that. That's why these things you are calling unordered elements. Okay, now because of OL numbers you are getting by default, because of UL dot symbols by default you are getting. Okay, and this content guys, this content if you want to display using LI tag, we are going to be displaying this content using LI. Okay, so here also guys, this content using LI we are displaying, means in between OL tag LI we are writing, or in between UL tag LI we are writing. Clear? So this is the concept about the list items. Now we will display content guys like this way. Okay, so open our page. Now create one more HTML. Right click on this folder, click on the new, and now click on HTML, and now here give file name. So list items guys, list items, I'm taking our file name like a list items dot html. okay, list items dot html we are taking. Okay, and here some default code coming. You don't worry. Slowly you will understand. I'll tell that one next session. Okay, so basic code can see HTML, and inside that head code is there. Head, and now inside that title, guys. So title is the list items, guys. List items I'm taking, and now body, guys. Body, we can write body. In the body, guys, I want to use h2 tags, h2. So available languages, available languages are like I'm displaying. Okay, so next, one more h2, available databases are. Okay, right now can execute this. So you're getting like this, available languages, available databases. Okay, so now here I want to use order list, guys. OL, order list. In between the order list, LI, list items. So I'm going to use Python, guys. Python language. Control D, duplicate. So now here, Java language and C language, .NET language, like whatever you want, you can take it. Okay, now here, guys. So UL tag I'm using, unordered. In this LI, we are using LI. Okay, now MySQL database, or simply MySQL DB. Control D, duplicate, guys. Keep your mouse on this line. Control D, duplicate. You are getting. So Oracle, and now MongoDB. Okay. So now can see you're getting like this. Got it? This presentation, guys. So available languages, so on. So available databases, so on. So like you are getting because of OL tag. These numbers you are getting by default. Because of LI, this content you are getting. Because of UL, unordered, dot symbol, guys, disk symbols you are getting. And because of LI, content you are getting. Okay, now? Okay. In the coming days, guys, by writing the CSS, these numbers I don't want. I want like this. Python. Okay, next B, like a Java. Okay, like that ABC characters, upper characters we can do. Otherwise, if you want to be lower characters, you can give it. Otherwise, Roman numbers there, guys. Lower Roman numbers. 1, this is the 2, this is the 3, and this is the 4, and this is the 5, like Roman numbers there, guys. And upper Roman numbers also 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Okay, now so whatever the format you want, you can take it by writing the CSS. By writing some CSS styles, we can do it. Okay, and here also, guys, by default dots, disk symbols you're getting, round disk symbols. And if you want like this, small square shapes, guys. Squares, you can get it by writing the CSS. Okay, and also dot, this is what, round symbol, circles, guys, like a circles. Okay, small circles, guys, here for drawing purpose, you are not coming properly. Okay, round circles you are going to be getting, maybe disk symbols or maybe squares or maybe round shapes. We can write using the UL tag, unordered. These all are unordered. But these all are ordered related. Come on, is it clear so far about the ordered and unordered with LI elements? So when we are going for order list, means if you want to represent like this counting numbers, then you can go for order list. And we can use unordered list if you don't want to specify numbers. Count, if you don't want to specify, then go with unordered list. but in both li and l ul sorry in both ul tag and ol tag li tag is must be required to display this content that's it about the order list and unordered list. So when we are developing the applications, guys, sometimes required these ol and ul tags. That time we can display like that. So this is just normal content I displayed. So here above you can write more names. So welcome to NTH providing below courses, what course is providing, like whatever you want, you can design it. Okay, so if you are understanding this one, then I will discuss another concept. So far major tags, guys, major tags. So h1 tag to h6 tags, simply header tags we discussed. Now paragraph tags also discussed. Okay, after that table related, guys, table family, table tags means these all tags you need to remember combination. Okay, next, guys, list tags. Okay, list tags means these all you need to be remembered. Okay, these all tags when we are designing big applications, most of the times we are going to use. So those things first we are planning. Okay, na? So those guys, square shapes and circle shapes, by writing the CSS, we can write, we can get it. So right now CSS how writing you don't know, that's why wait some time. At the time of discussing the CSS, I will show you. So don't ask, guys, here how to get Roman numbers. I'm telling, we can also get like that, but using CSS. Right now CSS related I didn't discuss it. CSS rules I didn't discuss it. That's why I'm not telling right now. Okay, now we have this session, that time I'll tell definitely. Otherwise, the people who know some basics about the HTML, they are interested to learn right now, now only, how to display squares, how to display round shapes, all the things. But the people who don't know basics, then those people are getting confusing. Why CSS writing here? I don't know CSS rules like that. They are thinking. Okay, now? So wait some time, guys. Now, next, so far p tag we know, guys, same like p tag, p means para, same like we have pre tag, p and pre like one family. So p tag for displaying the paragraphs related we can write. Okay, so now pre tag is okay, na? Pre tag, using pre what we can do now, can see, guys. PRE means free formatted text. Free formatted text. So here I want to be right, guys. See one special tag there here, HR. HR means horizontal row. Horizontal row. If you are using this tag, guys, so like this, one horizontal line you are going to be getting. One horizontal line you are getting. And this tag not required end tag. I told you guys all open tags required end tag, but not 100%. I told most of the tags required open and end. Some tags not required end tag, only open tag enough, no content also. Okay, so now this tag behavior is a horizontal line we are going to be getting. See this line you are going to be getting, horizontal line, HR tag. If you want to be separating something, okay, then we can use this HR tag. Okay, so next, guys, some special tags, small tags we will discuss. Right now here, three things there, three allies there. After displaying Python language, one BR tag I'm using. BR means break the row. Break the row, guys. So after displaying this content, So because of this one line gap you are going to be getting. One line gap you are going to be getting. Break the row means next row. Next row you are going to be getting, guys. Yeah. Wait, guys. I will put charging here. Yes. So now can see I used BR. Now output can observe. Output. See, guys. Here one line gap you are getting. One line gap you are getting. Because of BR. Because of BR. Okay. So you can see here. The same BR, guys. I'm going to use. Here I'm going to use BR. Which means up to here displaying. After that, because of BR, next line coming. In this next line, this further content going to be displaying. So one line, guys, if you want to break like multiple lines, then you can use BR. See, available languages are bottom side coming because of BR. These all are small, small tags, special tags. Depending on requirement, we can use it. Okay? So, yes, I use it now. So, HR tag I use it, guys. Here, I want to do something. Now, one paragraph. So, welcome to HTML concept. Okay, welcome to HTML concept. So, dot. Next, guys, another line I'm taking. Another line. So, welcome to NTH, for example. Okay. So, now here, welcome to HTML. More lines gap I taken, guys. More lines, not lines, more spaces I taken gap. Okay. And also here, more lines gap also taken here. Okay. Here, more spaces taken. Here, more lines taken. So open tag here, there, close tag here, there. Okay, now? Now, if we are executing this paragraph tag, guys. So from open tag to up to end tag, it consider like a single line. It consider like a single line. In middle, n number of lines, if you are getting gap here, n number of lines, if you are getting gap, this paragraph tag not going to be considered. Not considering, that is one rule. And here, guys, if you are getting n number of spaces, these all spaces consider like a single space, considering like a one single space. Here, one single space there, guys. Like that, after the two, one more single space coming and followed by HTML coming. Okay, now? So now can see I'm executing this one. See, you're getting what? After welcome to, lot of gap we taken, but you are getting only single space. Okay, after the HTML concept, guys, welcome to HTML concept. This is after some lines gap we taken, but you are getting in the same line. Okay, that is a paragraph related behavior. Paragraph behavior. Okay, now we have PRE tag, guys. We have what? PRE tag, I told right now. Free formatted text. Whatever the order I'm displaying content, whatever the order I'm creating inside my HTML, same order I want to display. For example, see, the same code I'm going to use here, guys. One more HR separation I'm taking. Now here I'm using. Okay, between this para and this one, you're going to get one original line. So here PRE we can use. See, guys, I'm changing here. Automatically bottom tag also changing. End tag. If you are changing here, automatically end tag also changing. That is a PyCharm benefit. One benefit. Okay. Yeah. So now here P tag I used. Now here PRE tag I used. Output can see, guys. Using PRE, whatever the spaces you are taking, all spaces countable as is getting like this. And what are the lines you are taking gap? All lines also countable. So whatever the format you are giving here, same format you are going to be getting. Now can see. can see guys. Okay, so here as a single line you are getting, but here lot of gap you are taking, the same gap taking, and a lot of lines gap you are taking, all the lines also taking. That is a free RE tag behavior, free format, nothing but paragraph only, but input what format we are writing, same format output we are getting. Okay, so PRE tag generally we are using at the time of displaying the address guys, address. So general addresses, how to displaying guys, for example NTH, okay, NTH, Amirpet, okay, and like this, multiple lines vertically we are writing. Simply you can open PRE tag, you can close the PRE tag, in middle, n number of lines code you can write, normal content, line by line, okay, NTH, Amirpet, so-and-so, building, so-and-so, area like that, contact number, all the things you can give. As this format you're going to get vertically. If you are giving here a paragraph, if you are using paragraph tag, all content horizontally displaying, NTH, comma, Amirpet, comma, so and so like. That's why use a PRE tag whenever you're going to be displaying the address related information in your website. Come on, is it understanding? Difference between P tag and PRE tag. Okay, now? So in the notepad, guys, every open tag, we need to close end tag also. And if you are changing in open tag, end tag also, we need to change it. But using PyCharm readymadely, open tag related end tag coming, and open tag changing means automatically end tag also changing. Okay. So sometimes we are going to use PRE at the time of displaying the address kind of information. So that's why I given information here. Okay. So next guys, next another tags. Whatever the tags I'm explaining here, these all are very, very important tags guys. HTML having n number of tags, but first we need to be focused regularly what we are using those tags. Next guys. Whenever we are seeing different websites, guys, like Amazon, Flipkart, so many are there. So in most of these websites, guys, links we are getting, links we are seeing. Okay. Whenever we are clicking particular link, then we are getting something. For example, one link is there, guys, here one link is there. Okay. So Facebook, like one link is there, guys, here. Links like this underline displaying. Okay, so here blah 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 writing, and again blah 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 writing. So here like a underline their link. So whenever you are clicking here, okay, then immediately Facebook related page opened, Facebook page opened. Okay, now? So these links guys, how to creating, that is now we will discuss. So when we are designing the applications, websites, guys, lot of times links we are creating. Links, for example, Python tutorials you want to follow, HTML tutorials you want to follow. Then in Google you are searching. Then lot of links displaying. Whatever the link you want, you are going to be clicking. That link related content displaying. Same thing now we are going to be designing. Okay, now? So HTML links, guys. Or else web page links, HTML links, how to creating. This is now concept. Okay. By using anchor tag as one tag is there. A tag. Simply by using anchor tag. So this is the A guys tag. We are calling anchor. Anchor tag, okay, a tag full name we are calling anchor tag. So by using the anchor tag guys, by using anchor tags, we can display html links, or else by using anchor tags we can display our web page related links guys. We can display links on our web page. Okay, so syntax, can see guys, syntax. So links related syntax. So open tag is there guys, open tag is there. Okay, and followed by h reference attribute is there. Attribute, this is one attribute. Here some value you are going to be writing. Later we will discuss what value. Now close it. Okay, and now content guys, so whatever the content you want you can display, and now close the anchor tag. This is the syntax guys. A tag with a h reference value. H reference means hyper reference. The full name if you are not remembering also no problem, but whenever you are using anchor tag, H reference attribute is a mandatory attribute followed by content. So whenever you are using this tag guys, this content as a user we can see whenever you are clicking this content then this H reference value related link going to be opened. So here destination link guys, destination means after clicking where we want to go, or else what we want to display, that related link we are going to be displaying. Okay, na? So h reference value is some destination location guys, where you want to go, what you want to open, like that. After clicking this destination going to be executing. That is anchor elements behavior. So why we are using anchor elements to displaying the HTML related links, we are using the anchor elements. That is the concept. Come on, up to here understanding all people, give one confirmation here. Yeah, okay. So next guys, what is the use of links? What is the use of links? Means HTML links are used to establish the linking between two web pages or else two locations of each of current web page. So can see here links we are using for what purpose, means HTML links guys. HTML links are used to establish means connection, making connection, to establish the linking between two web pages. Okay, na? HTML links are used to establishing the, or else to making the linking between two web pages. Means from Facebook page to YouTube page, Facebook page to Gmail page. Okay, I'm going to developing my current HTML like a demo HTML. In that demo HTML, one link going to be creating. Whenever clicking the link, then jumping to somewhere. So this is called one web page to another web page, one application to another application. Communication, if you want to do using the HTML links, we can do. Okay, or else, and we can make the connection between two locations, guys. Okay, so making connection. Connection between two locations of same web page. This is important guys. What is the use of HTML links? Can see. So HTML links are used to establishing the linking between the two web pages, or else making the connection between two locations guys, to locations of same web page. To locations of same web page. Okay, na? So that is the HTML links behavior. So can see guys, I'm developing one application here. This is app one. App one. Okay. So next we have another application. This is app two. App two. So from this application we have one link. Whenever we are clicking this link, okay, then immediately I want to jump to another application, and this application related content I want to display here. So this is app to app communication, okay? And within the one application, one location to another location, guys. Location one, simply location one is there. Location two is there. Location three is there. Like n number of locations there, guys, in current HTML. Okay. So whenever you are clicking this link, guys, whenever you are clicking this location one link, then immediately I want to jump to here. I want to jump to here. This is within the current application only. For example, app one. So within the application, guys, here vertical scroll bar you are getting. Vertical scroll bars you are getting. Okay, na? So from one location to another location within the page, directly we can jump. If I'm clicking here, directly I will jump to bottom. Again, if I'm clicking here, directly I can jump to top. Like that, within the page, between two locations, if you want to make the communication, we can use the links. Clear about the HTML links behavior? Okay, yes. I told guys, h reference means hyper reference, hyper reference. So if you are not remembering also full name, no problem, but using h reference, what we can do, what we need to give here, that is important. After clicking this link, where you want to go, that destination related link we are giving here, destination path we are giving here, guys. So whenever people are clicking this one, this link, then we are redirecting to this location, this location. That is H reference behavior. Okay, then? So top to bottom, bottom to top, using the links we can travel. So remember that point. Now HTML links, guys, HTML links, we are dividing like two types. HTML links are dividing, guys. HTML links are dividing two types. Dividing like two types. Dividing like two types. Okay. One is interlinking, guys. One is interlinking. Interlinking. And another one is intralinking. 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 Okay, so HTML links are like two types of dividing. One is the interlinking concept, another one is the intralinking concept. Interlinking and intralinking. Okay, then? So now what is interlinking and what is intralinking? We need to discuss. So guys, only displaying the links, this is enough. This is enough. Okay, then? But using this one, some specialization we can create for the links. First, normal links we can create. Can see normal links I'm going to be creating. So here I'm going to be taking some links, guys. Some links. Okay, now. So here a tag followed by h reference. Okay, followed by destination. You can give, guys. Destination www.facebook.com www.facebook.com. okay, so remember that. Now here click me, okay, or else open Facebook whatever you want, you can take it. Whatever you want, you can take it. Open Facebook. That is guys. Okay. So where is the link? Here they are link. So links by default, blue color you are getting guys. Blue color. And also underline you are getting. Underline. Okay, no? Underline. Now click this one. Then 404. So Facebook means HTTP. That is also, remember, facebook.com. So this is Facebook, guys. Now you can use inside our coding. Where is my HTM? Now here. So remove this. Now candy. This is missing. That's why you're not getting. HTTPS. Okay. So facebook.com. Now open our page. So this is our page, guys. Okay. So this is our application. Our application. Now, if you are clicking this. So what is happen? NTHWW Facebook. H reference. Wait. Rerun. Now coming. Previous one not affected. Okay. After clicking the link, guys, you are getting the Facebook. You are getting the Facebook. Okay. So if you are getting back, this is our page. From this application to after clicking this Facebook page, communicating means one application to another application, we communicated. This is called interlinking, guys. This is called interlinking concept. So our current application replacing by Facebook. Okay, now? Yeah. So, okay, guys, don't worry. Linking related, again, next session we will discuss. Right now, time is over. Again, people are having the Python class. Okay. So links related, I'll tell in the next class. So interlinking and intralinking with specialization attributes there. Using those all attributes, we will discuss. Like this, writing links, all people knows, guys. But you need to have some special things, special knowledge. So how to do those things in the next session, we will discuss. Okay, now? Yes. Yeah. So, and also, guys, some people here asking regularly, sir, we are not getting the documentation like that. So, in the next class, guys, okay, I mean, this class related, Google Drive, I will share, guys, Google Drive related links. I will upload to in Google Drive, guys. Okay, now? So, from there, you can access. You can access. So, sir will share you that Google Drive related links. You will get it clearly. Okay, now? Yes. So, I'll stop now recording.